somebody murdered a lot. I think that you are going by the grace of Allah. Corona has broken out all over the world. It has created panic throughout the world. Always follow the rules of health. If you follow the rules of health, you will remain healthy. Hope that due to coronavirus, you all are at your home. Now, I am going to take online class for this video. Let's go to the blackboard. You have to write this. Okay, my dear learners, or or a verb is a word that tells something about a person or a thing written by rain and Martin. You have to write this. Okay, my dear learners. Or a bar having or doing something, my daughter does not write this. I think you should learn it. Written by पी सी दास। ओके माय डियर लालास, काइंड्स ऑफ भाव यू शुड हैव नोन इट। आई थिंक यू नो दैट भाव इज डिवाइडेड इनटू टू क्लासेस। भाव इज डिवाइडेड इनटू टू मेन क्लासेस। दे आर you have to write this, I think you should learn it. Now, my dear learners, what is finite verb? What is called finite verb? I think you know that. The verb whose completes the speech of a sentence, it is called finite verb. You have to write this. Okay, my dear learners, e.g. for example, he went to Dhaka. Here is a verb. Here is the place of verb went. It is for finite verb. The verb was complex by speech of a sentence. This is why it is for finite verb. I think, my dear learners, you know that the verb is a core word. The verb is the core word in a sentence. Without a verb, a group of words is not a sentence. It is the most important part of a sentence. In question and comments, the verb is the first word in the sentence. Next, what is non-finite verb? I think you know that the verb who is doesn't complete the is this of a sentence, it is called non-finite verb. Okay, my dear learners, have you understood? I think you have understood this matter. E.g., for example, he wanted to go to Dhaka. Here is the place of verb to go. It doesn't complete the speech of a sentence. This is why it is called non-finite verb. Okay, my dear learners, you have to write this. They are. My dear learners, in simple verb, auxiliary verb. You have to write this. You should learn it. It is very important for you. Now, what is principal verb? I concede. You know that the verb is the verb is used independently. It is called principal verb. He comes here. Here is the place of comes. It is used independently. This is why it is called principal verb. Okay, my dear learners, what is called principal auxiliary verb? I think you know that the verb is used. जिला विभाग या प्रोवाइड दिस आपके माइडर लर्नर्स इजी फॉर एग्जांपल For example, he is coming here. He is running in the field. My dear learners, you have to learn a base word, calm. Remember that why is he drop before ing. So why is he drop before ing? You should learn it. It is a good point. My dear learners, I think you know that when a verb ends in a singular e, this is drop. Okay, my dear learners, again, when a verb ends in a single E, this E is dropped before ing. Now, questions, my dear learners, you have to learn it. It is very important to know that the word is and is double before ing. Why is and is double before ing? You should learn it. Remember that, my dear learners, when a verb is of one syllable, when a verb is of one syllable, has a having one vowel and ends in a consonant, this consonant is double before ing. As for example, seed, si double t, ing sitting, swim, S-W-I-M, S-W-I-M, M-I-N-G, swimming. Okay, my dear learners. Kinds of principal verb. I think you know that principal verb is of two kinds. Principal verb is of two kinds. They are. My dear learners, you have to learn it. Principal verb is of two kinds. They are. Que no te